Okay, my friends, I don't even know what they brought me. They brought me a huge assortment here. So obviously, look at this. We got the pretzel. Good evening, everyone. This is David Hoffman from Davidsbeenhere, coming at you from beautiful, sunny Odessa, Ukraine. Today is a beautiful day. Finally, we've had two really rough days in terms of weather. So much rain, but today, as you can see, super sunny. What we're gonna do right now is I'm gonna take you around the central part of the city, showing you some of the main attractions, and then after this, we're gonna have dinner at Gabrunus. It's a super famous beer restaurant, dates back to 1906. 1906, 115 years. I'm super excited, I'm hungry, and I can't wait to explore.
It's an opera house, the most beautiful in the world. It's not I who saying this, but the Viennese architect who built it. 1867.
If you've never been to the opera house in Vienna, this one looks identical from the outside. Really beautiful, monster building. There's horses in the front, just like in Vienna. You have horse carriages, right? And to the side, you have a huge fountain where everybody's gathering. Beautiful day, families are out, everybody's relaxing, chilling by the fountain, some people dancing over there, a lot of people on these like go-peds, these are like the Ubers here. Everybody, you know, they have a card for that. You just go around the city, and we're gonna walk down to the left and pass by another beautiful building and see right over there is the port, right?
It's a town hall. On the top, we have two figures, day and night, and the clock below, and the clock chimes every hour and half an hour, a very popular song about Odessa from a popular music movie.
Right in front of the town hall, we have Prymorskyi Boulevard, which is basically a pedestrian walkway that's shaded right next to the sea. It reminds me of the one they have in Varna, Bulgaria, which I think is called the Sea Garden. And you can see there's some artists here. So this lady's like painting with spray paint. Awesome, really cool. And over here, we have people dancing and singing over here.
David, when they redid all this boulevard, they left one part uncovered to show us what we are walking on. And you see, they found different pieces like Greek amphoras here, Greek coins, old Greek anchor. But this stone with a piece of wood, it's anchor. It's an old Greek anchor.
So they found Greek artifacts all throughout this. If you guys didn't know, the Greeks founded this city like 2,500 years ago. But you know, they didn't really stay here. They were in a different area, but it was called Odessa, right? Odessos. Odessos was the Greek name. And we're here back at Potemkin Stairs, 192 stairs that go down to the port. You can walk all the way down and come back up, or you can do what most people do and take the funicular back up. But it's a beautiful day, lots of people out, lots of vendors here. They also have some crafts over here as well. And I think we still have a bridge to see right over here, a bridge?
Mother-in-law bridge.
Okay, so they named it mother-in-law for what reason? And we made it here to the bridge, and from here we have incredible views looking over the port, the grain port. And this is the palace. So this palace is called Voronov Palace? Voronsov Palace from the mid 19th century. And where I'm standing right now, this is part of their like private estate, right? But then later during Soviet times, they removed it, they removed all fences, and this became open to the public. So why do they call it the mother-in-law bridge? Well, they built this bridge over a ravine, right? Close to the port. And at the very end, up there, there's another bridge, but that one is cars and pedestrians. This one's only pedestrians. So people made up a lot of stories, and they said that one of the stories was there was a boss over here that lived on this side, his mother lived on the other side, right? And then he loved her pancakes, but she would have to take the bridge to bring the pancakes. So instead they built the bridge. I mean, there's a few other stories with it, but they're all long. Just know this is the bridge you should go to. You know, it's a good walk from here. You could do all this. What we just did was less than an hour, not so bad. Like most of the most famous bridges in Europe, this one, they used to allow you to do your love locks. Basically, couples come, they put the lock, they write their name on it, they throw away the key. But what happened is the bridge started to slowly go down. So they decided, you know what, we're gonna cut all the locks, and they set up this one, a big heart, right? And you could put your love lock, and now it's basically full. I mean, there's a few spots, but completely full, right? Huge ones. You have small ones, you have kid ones, but this is the biggest one. Look at this.
It's the main street of Odessa called Deribasovska. It's pedestrian street because no transport is allowed here.
Like most cities in the world, this is the main pedestrian street, right? So here you're gonna find all the restaurants, bars, coffee shops. You know, this is where everybody comes, especially around 5 p.m. Right now it's 7:30, but it's entering summer, so the sun's gonna be out for a little while longer. And the restaurant we're going to is down this street, right? A little farther down. Great, yeah, I mean, this is families, people hanging out. Beautiful street. And here where you see all these people gathered hearing music, you make a left and this is the restaurant. And I was actually wrong, it's 1883. Somebody online put it incorrectly. So this is Gambrinus, since 1883. That is really, really old. Wow, that is 137 years? That is crazy. So it's basically like an underground tavern in this stone like cellar, right? They have lots of beers, more like macro breweries, but they also make their own beer, which I'm trying right here. I don't even know what it is. Let's see. Oh, and they also give you like croutons, right? It's a lager. It's a little malty though. Not just your ordinary lager. I love this place. So, live music, good food, good beer. Their menu's awesome. It's like a newspaper. This is how life used to be before the internet. We don't remember this anymore. And the live music, incredible. It's like Odessa music, right? Dark beer, so they have flights of beer. So you can get a set, right? You can buy the glass too if you want. You can buy this. It's $250, so $10 for the glass. Oh, they also have cognac, they have brandy, they have appetizers, but they have a lot of fish. Obviously, they have meat, but if you're here, you gotta have fish. So I'm gonna get some fried fish. I don't know exactly what I'm gonna get. I usually never look at the menu, so you know that's what I'm gonna do this time. I'm not looking at the menu. Give it to them, send me whatever you want. And our first dish is, wow, two different fishes, right? This is from the Black Sea, both of them. They're fried. This one I had yesterday, incredible fish, very tasty. And this right here costs $2.50, so $10 for this. I think it's a good deal for a whole assortment of fish, fried though. And next to it we have tartare, right? Yeah. Barabulka. Barabulka. So what you do, you're supposed to like break off the head, right? And then go in and grab everything. Take off the spine. So it's goat fish and gobies. I have no idea, my friends. Can't wait. Oh, wow. The meat here. Oh, but to be honest, I love this. The sauce. Oh, it's just being careful with this though, because look at all the bones. It's gotta pull out all the meat, separate it. Oh, it's a lot. So tasty. Oh, I love the outside. You wanna try the other one? So rip the head off, right? Dip. Yeah, you gotta definitely bite a lot, like chew like crazy, because of all the spines, right? Tartar sauce, delicious tartar sauce. I'll tell you, today's my last night in Ukraine. I'm super tired. I'm forgetting things. I said tartar earlier, tartar sauce. The good thing is they brought me a new beer, so I'm gonna flush it down. This is a different one, it's like a dark beer. This is an amber. Nice. Amber's like a, almost like a red ale. I'm enjoying this. Love it. I can eat fish forever. Tartar sauce right after. 137 years, you're eating bar food, but you know, with history. Incredible. It's really good. This one's actually the tastiest, but it's the one with the most bones. Gobi. Let's get in here and pull out flesh. Oh wow. The taste is so unique. Look at this. It's right here. Pour everything out. This just needs a little bit of tartar. The whole thing falls apart. Jamming on. Okay, my friends, I don't even know what they brought me. They brought me a huge assortment here. So obviously, look at this. We got the pretzel. This is like very German. I'm good with this. Over here we have onion rings, French fries, chicken wings. What are these? Fish balls. And over here, ribs. And over here we have schmack, right?
Fish schmack.
Vorschmack. So vorschmack is basically a fish pate, and you have incredible rye bread on the side. I'm actually overdoing it with all this food, but hey, one life, right? Holy fuck, ribs, crazy. It almost tastes like Chinese chicken wings. The sauce they use. Whoa. So delicious. I'm gonna try one onion ring. You know what? I'm gonna add a sauce on top. Why not? Let's eat. I love onion rings way more than fries. These fries, though, it was okay. And right here, we have chicken wings. That just falls apart. Ooh, it's still super hot. First time having this type of food here in the Ukraine. This is like for real bar food. And the fish balls, add some of that tartar sauce every day. But look at this. Today I'm extremely tired. I said Chinese chicken wings? No. What am I saying? Chinese delicious pork ribs. Same thing. Same sauce. It's my last night, so I guess I'm expanding my stomach. These little fish balls. And keep them coming. Crunchy. Oh, with that. Vorschmack. Now I'm getting it. So you just get a piece like this. Oh, and it has the bread on the bottom as well right now. I want to do like a Viking. It's basically fish tartare. That's what it is, right? Let's mix it in here with this. This one's obviously just way more basic compared to the one we had dacha. That one was like way more just mix of things, and you can see the chunks of fish. This is more like a puree. The rest of that food, I'm taking it to go. I'm gonna give it to somebody in need. I'm gonna finish this beer. At least I can't leave. Well, my friends, that is it. We explored this city, saw the main attractions. I mean, this is what you could do from like 5 p.m. to 9 p.m., which is 9 p.m. right now, and went to this 137-year-old tavern, Ukrainian tavern, had some delicious beer, fish, pork ribs. I mean, really, really good. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. Leave me a comment below. Subscribe to my channel for more awesome travel content. I'll see you in the next travel food adventure. Oh, I have no idea where. I'll see you soon.